Morning. We're here at Jude and Rex Sugarbush in Prince Edward County. It's March 6th. Thought I'd do a quick little video to show our evaporator. Last year we had a local welder from Wellington put two 45-gallon drums together. I cut in the top openings for these stainless steel pans. We have an 8-inch chimney this year. Last year it was a 6, but I put an 8 on to get a better draw. I think that's really working, certainly going through the wood. And of course a door to load fuel and a vent area. And I've got a small fan blowing air into the wood box to give us the hottest burn we can get. Our method of keeping this evaporator going is we take our 10-liter jugs that we use for collection, and we're pouring the cold sap into this first tray, and this is furthest from the hot part of the fire, so it's like pre-warming. And then as each of the trays to my left, your right, need sap in the boiling process, I just manually moving that across tray to the next, and I'm drawing from each tray because there's quite a temperature difference as I move down the line here. And this fourth tray, by the end of the day, it'll look a lot like syrup, and it'll be ready to take to the house for the polishing step. I use a propane boiler and stainless steel pots and filter. I filter after this process at the evaporator, and then I'll filter again before bottling. I've got a little scoop here with a mesh on it to pick up foam and bits of debris that have accumulated in the collection process. So you obviously want to try and get that out as early as you can, and just discard that. So like I said, we're hoping to get through around 200 liters of sap today, and we're well into it at about 90 right now, so I guess I better get back to splitting wood. So hope you found that informative. That's what we're doing here, and we're having a ball, living the dream. Thanks for watching.